Okay, recording because recording is cool. So, goal is to write parsers. Let's see. Rust parse integer. Dot parse. Real? Alright. Let's see. Okay, what about where's the freaking client? Let's do NJ actually. What? Am I on old version? What the hell? Huh? Did I just freaking... Okay. Oh, I'm gonna die. Did that work? Yeah, okay. That looks weird, but okay. I don't know. Alright, integer, string, boolean. I mean, string is trivial. F. Is that real? Awesome. All right. Curious. Let's see. Okay. Parse int error cannot be formatted with the default formatter. Okay. Holy, what? Okay. What happens? Invalid digit. Didn't I? The turbofish operator, I see. I see. Match the error. Oh, shit. Okay, I don't understand. Why did it compile? Okay, what if I do this? Okay, well, this guy says to do it like this. Oh, it's right here. Okay. Real? Oh. Unused variable. Okay. Can I go like this? Okay. Ooh. Okay. I'm so confused. Oh. Is it the new line? It's the new line, isn't it? What does pop do? I'm now obsessed. String with zero copy. Pop. So, well, then that doesn't work here. Okay, let's do. Actually, that'd be useful for all of these. You know what? Fuck it. Yeah. All right. Worked. Yeah, I figured it out. True. Okay. Match. That sounds like. All right, I'm looking it up. Rust match. Pattern matching. The first matching arm is evaluated and all possible values must be covered. Does it just iterate? Probably not. It probably. I mean, it's probably good. Regardless. Okay. Oh, so I can do this now. Ah. Yeah. Why didn't I think of that? Why does it include the new line? It's kind of dumb. Shush. Begin unwind. Holy. Full. Ooh. 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 Wow. Does the program know how to do? How big is this binary? Mm-hmm. 10 killing bytes. What if I do this? Okay. Wow. Optimized. All right, what about this? Same size. Oh. Okay, what if I run it? 2. Whoa. ASDF. So now if I do this, does it die? Libc. I mean, it's cool. Okay, it's something. That's probably my favorite Michael Jackson song. So probably Get will be used in the final. Just because it can skip if it doesn't exist. Instead of freaking exploding. Tonight, leave the 9 to 5 up on the shelf and just enjoy yourself. So, I think I figured out what I wanted to figure out, and I can put it actually into something tomorrow. What you want to do, there ain't no rules, it's up to you. Okay, this can be part of this. So you can substring a stir as well, I'm sure. I'm just gonna try it. Let's try it. All right, what if I go like one? Let's try that. Ooh. All right. So now I do a two. Hey, wow, it worked. So it's I think it's making no copies. This is a weird thing to do, but I wonder if the compiler is mega advanced and just like works it out or something. That would be impressive. That's very cool. Wow, okay. Cool. I don't want to stop. What do I want to do then? I can't help it if I wanted to. Oh, hold up. Option, does option mean as like a list of things it could be? Okay, so has to contain the commands space. Oh man, just towering mountain above me. I'm so excited to climb. Above me, in front of me. How long did I spend on this? 30 minutes? I think my curiosity is satisfied here. Array of functions. Okay, so I could. Go through each function and attempt to parse args. But what if I already have a set? Already have parsed args because of explicit specified parsers. Right. Okay, this is actually coming together. I'll just keep it like this. So, if you don't explicitly specify parsers, it will try to fill in the data. Wow. My head is buzzing with ideas. So I could have like so list of command aliases. Permission. Just say this because like it's goofy looking and it's funny. Oh goodness. If I have a how would I do a function with an unknown number of arguments? I mean, I haven't I haven't really needed it. Because, like, I could just have a list parser type. Maybe I do permission first. But, like, this is. Obviously, it's adding the kill command. Kill player function. And then the parsers. And then it like, or oh god, I could have like options. Oh my god, endless possibilities. Is this how option works? So I could have. Yeah, so player ID. Oh no. Player ID. Then special. Or unspecified parsers attempts all available parser combinations. The complexity is kept in check by parser failure aborting early. The rest of the combination tree early. Okay, let's see what option means. Rust option. Okay, so what does this mean? Okay, so it's not what I was saying, what I wrote. Oh, but I can read it. But what's that? I don't know what that is. Okay, what's that other code I saw? Where you could have multiple types. It's the megafish operator. Okay, so this is not what I so this is a set, really. Rust set. I mean, set is like, unlucky. Hash set. Yeah, so I don't need this. It can literally just be a sort of special list, I guess. Very, very nice. Very nice. Oh my god. This goes stupid. I have absolutely outdone myself with this idea, and I'm going to fucking explode and die trying to write this. And that's kind of the idea. So, how does this map into the hash map? So, this guy gets multiple functions. Yeah. Wait. Really like this syntax. This is cool. So then, I mean, that's basically a friggin' global, but I mean, it's still explicit. This is just a bit flag, so I don't know. But like the double colon looks cool. I don't know. It looks so cool. I guess I'll go like this. Okay, let's look it up. Turbo fish. What the flap? Why? Imagine if this is like literally just exactly the thing implemented. Lamau. Literally undecidable. Lamau. ASTU, what is that? That's not what I was looking for, but it was cool to read about. Okay, I don't know. I'll figure that one out later. I really want to use the gnome thing where I put my mouse in the corner to alt tab. Kill. No. Oh. Array of functions. It's more of a set, if I'm being honest. Because it doesn't include. Okay, so if it's a set of functions. It's a set of functions. With valid parser combinations. Beow. Set of functions. So each function. Indexed by function. That's. Does it have to be a hash map? No. It's just a list of tuples. So yeah, so it's a set of functions. So the functions are unique. That's why I was thinking the function is the index of a hash map. I see. Hashing a function is pretty goofy, but I am Lua-brained, so. So how do I set. Is it a set? Yeah, but like, fuck off. So it can be. Explicitly. So this means. Okay, so does that mean this can be ignored? If you can have literally any parser, then the parser sets are useless. I'm struggling, cause like they can be logically combined. If you do this, you specify the exact same dude, and then it goes into each one of these, and logically, I'm gonna write that down. Logically, parser valid parser sets are logically merged. Oh. This is implicitly the set parser list any, like parser any, and then it knows which parser exists. Player any something like that, which I don't know, should be none. Should it be a bit flag? I mean, bit flags are cool, but okay, parser. I mean, I know this is Rust syntax for something. Without sir player any, valid parsers becomes That's a lot of thinking. Always think twice. Any. Any or all. I don't know. Implicit's kind of bad. I mean, I don't know. So then I can do, okay, so if kill is like this, that so I can have it not affect the other entries. So K and kill can only be holy, I am thinking a little bit too hard about this, which I expected. I hecking love command parsing. So, permission admin, it's kind of a weird way to write a bit flag. Let's see, what does the old bit flag Rust doodad look like? Rust bit flags. Self. Fuck off. What? Jesus. So they are using these goobers. A. Oh, module. Okay, this is okay. I mean, a type save bitmask flag generator useful for some sets of C style flags. It can be used for wrappers on C APIs. Oh, I see. That is very cool. I'm going to use this. Holy shit. Okay, so what's this? Flags. Okay. Yeah. Parser, right. Okay, so probably it should exit when it determines that the parsing is not unique. So it will stop. Yeah. A boring. Parsing must be unique. Parsing must be unique. Evaluation is aborted if two parsings are found. Alternatively, instead of aborting, the user could be presented with a expandable list of parsing options. Wee. Well, my God, dude, when it's so endless possibilities. Admin commands. Use bit flags. All right, and then so permission owner is the highest bit or not. Admin map maker, don't need it. It's the perfect time. Yeah, obviously. What permissions do I have in my other Google? BYT, goodness. Oh my god, my Boolean. Alright. Ranks. Owner, admin, server owner, right. These should probably be tab aligned. Wait. Oh, right. Okay, so. It's fair. Hash. All right. With bit flags. So I found the code to use bit flags. Boom. Okay. Action function page just named strongly typed functions. It literally just. Literally. Just strongly typed functions. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Should I have perms? I can just add it later if I need to. Yeah, I basically have this figured out here. I just have to write an entire fucking everything. Oh, this is how Bhop started. I was like, bro. Admin commands? Freaking sweet. Okay, so it loops through each of these and adds. Uh-oh. No. Do I want to support that? Allow people with more permissions to have more parsers? I think that's a big no-no. The permission should be on the function itself, probably. Just like, yeah, I know. That's a really good point. The permission should be on the function itself. Action function itself. I don't need different permissions for different command aliases or parser combos. Period. So this syntax is bad. Did Rust add optional arguments? I remember reading about it. I think it was a controversy. If you come to Rust for optional arguments. Okay, well, now I understand unwrap. Trait. Oh my God. Implement default for name. What the foe? How old is this? There's no. Doesn't matter. Oh shit. Difference. That's really nice looking. So it just automatically makes all that garbage and I can just like use it easy. Okay, so permission doesn't belong here. Okay, so it's like this. Action add permission admin kill player, and then command add kill. Yeah, no, I can implement multiple. Yeah. I don't know. That this is, it's weird to have this and then this. Permission. I don't know. And then that's it. Woof. But then also whatever name. I can already see it. I'm gonna pin a core. I'm gonna get an infinite loop. Okay. So, I don't know. I can just say, like, you can only use kill by name, but then you can use these ones by ID. Because they'll be separate. God. This is nice. This is okay, having a different set of parsers for different shorthands. Oh, yeah, no, that's kind of good. So I could do let spectate action equals action add permission none. So, how do I specify empty. Flags dot clear. Dot zero. Huh. What a hell. So how do I do this? Empty. I don't know. And then, and add spectate action. Oh, so I could literally. So spectate, all, free willy all parsers for shorthand, but then for the longhand, parser only directly parse by name. For longhand. So spec me, spec auto, spec quad, spec me, spectate player named me, spectate self, named auto. Interesting. boxing is so freaking weird. So I don't know if I want bots to be too player like. I guess I'm in total control, so. The problem with this is that if there's a player named with me in their name, then it'll return, it'll, so I think it has to be like this. And then the logic is inside. God, this is so much fun. maybe you can't spectate bots with the long hand. I don't know. Yeah, I mean, it's okay, I think. This is really really developed now. That was in the wrong spot. Oof. Wow. I feel like a little kid again programming, but way fucking smarter. Or maybe it's experienced. Maybe I'm not smarter. This looks so juicy. I think I could spend a long time writing this. And it's okay because I'm learning Rust. Oh. Oh my God, bro. Okay. So, more thoughts. Sheesh. That's really goofy. Really, really goofy. Thought, what if you can specify as many command prefixes that you want? So, like exclamation point, semicolon, slash, and then you just like make words like ASDF is your prefix. And then what if there's a trillion of them, and how do you make it fast without scanning through each one? And I solved it, but like memory, haha. Just yeah, you basically just hash map by length, and then it's not slow. It's O of the number of lengths. But yeah, that was not a problem that needed to be solved. It was not a problem that needed to be solved. And now I've solved it in my head. This is beautiful, man. I'm going to avoid strings. I'm going to try my damnedest to avoid strings. So for a command system, you have to match a string. You have to match strings, so like, haha. But I could just call it strict. How did it? Okay. That's nice. That's really nicely named. Can I go like this? Damn. Lul, okay. So I can change this from an array to a tuple, maybe. So that I just directly double equals it. Cause like it seems like Rust actually implements that. Which is really neat. This is so overboard, it's not even funny. But that's what I'm here for. Is this allowed? Nope. Can I go like this? What happens if I do this? So Jackson. terrifying. This is terrifying. And I've never been this excited for something terrifying. I don't know if that actually describes it. Terrifying? Just monumental, probably is more accurate. So each, the idea, okay, I gotta write this down. The idea is that each alias has its own set of functions and parser combos. Lucky. Can I? I think it's just both, right? Very interesting. Okay, well, that's enough. He said confidently. I wonder if I should literally make it sets. It's pretty crazy. I think I'll be stuck with types. Like, crazy. Crazy stuck. Function types, just fucking everything types stuck. So the action has the permission. Then what about calling the action with a bind? Permission? I guess server actions have permissions. Client actions are all local. Okay, I'm thinking about networking now. So the client parses the command and finds no parsings. Parsingtons. It should immediately send it off to the server, right? What if the server finds parsings and the client finds parsings? Does the client, I feel like the client should not ever wait for the server to do a command that can be done fully local. So only attempt. So yeah, I could have it be separate parsings, client parse, server parse. Networking, man. Just share that code. Permission, though. Server needs permission. How do I do that better? I don't really want to move the permission into the function itself, because that's kind of, it's kind of nice to have the command know about the permission ahead of time. Command system, so it doesn't show up. But I guess it's not necessary. It could be entire command instances, and then it just calls it multiple times. It calls each instance that's available to the player. Oh, that's interesting, actually. Because then... then it doesn't even try... So instead of like this, it would be the action is literally just a function. And then it would be admin command. So let that's mutable. Admin command comment equal command new and then this is just the regular doofus except it has to be called something else and then regular doofus command doofus but better named permissionless command guest. And then, instead of having baked permissions, permissions are implemented as entirely separate command instances. Each instance the player has permission to execute is queried. Ambiguities are ambiguities. Inspected after may show up between different instances. Permissions are implemented as entirely separate command instances. That is insane. Sheesh. So I could combine this Doogle. This is a bad idea. I'm just going to delete it. So actions are literally just functions. Sheesh. Sheesh. Okay, so kill action player. I think what it's like this. Oops. Roblox moment. I don't like implicit return. Okay. Clarity. What took us so long? Who did this? There it is, disco song. Shalimar. Took us so long. Holy, every iteration here is better than the last. I'm loving the explicit parsers. can show up in the chat as buttons. If it's ambiguous, it shows up as buttons, and you can just click it. Holy. Alright, so, permission, fuck off. We don't do that anymore. It was like this, and then it was like this, and now it's... But I'll still use the bit flags for the thing that runs it. What a great song. Okay, I'm not tired. I should really go to bed, but there it is, what took us so long. All right. I've had my ideas. This is like getting to sort of legendary level command system. And it's not super, the parser merging could be hard. Well, no, actually. It just has to be a set, really. And then I just iterate over the set. Easy. Actually, it's fucking easy. So this is a tuple of sets. Okay, no, I guess it's an array of sets, and then it just happens to be the same length as the tuple. Argument inputs for this dude. There it is, what took us so long. I need this. Okay. It can be done. I'm gonna upload my ideas. How fucking big is this? To where? I don't wanna spam its names. Uber. I mean, it's supposed to be the one. I forgot. How do you do submodules? There it is. Get submodules. Wow. Submodule add. Ooh. URL. What if it's not at a URL? Well, whatever. Okay. Yeah, this is just searchingtons. Okay. This is on my hard drive. I want to put it. Not sure if this needs to be its own entire repository. I guess this is for testing. I don't know. I'm kind of planning to go pretty crazy with it. Get jiggy with it. I mean, of course it still builds. Okay. Nice. Okay. Goodbye. I'm going to lie down, I guess.